Hey everyone, it's Jenson Strock with WTOL. Thank you for joining me in some afternoon tea. There are some news stories I want to share with you all before we get into the main story this afternoon. But before we do any of that, let me show off what I'm munching on. Today I made some monster cookies because they're quick and easy and delicious, and I woke up late and they're filled with peanut butter and oatmeal, M&Ms, chocolate chips, everything that a growing girl needs. And this drink you see is from Maddie and Bella in downtown Toledo. It is their chai latte, so there's some tea in there, right? And it is on ice because it's like 98 degrees outside. Shout out to you, Nick Lachey. I hope he's doing okay. But on to the news.
Cedar Point is back on Thursday, but with a number of changes. Hours will be reduced to 11 a.m. until 8 p.m. Reservations are required, as are masks. Guests will also have their temperature taken, and anyone with a fever of more than 100.4 will be sent packing.
But on the brighter side, there are a number of new restaurants that you can visit to fill your tummies before you then propel yourself at 93 miles per hour.
And on Tuesday, Ohio Governor Mike DeWine announced a mask order in 7 counties that goes into effect at 6 o'clock tonight. Those counties are Huron, Cuyahoga, Franklin, Montgomery, Hamilton, Trumbull, and Butler. So here's when masks must be worn in those specific counties. In any indoor location that's not a residence. When they're outdoors and unable to maintain 6 feet of distance from anyone who's not a member of their household, and while they're waiting for, riding, or driving in a taxi, rideshare, or some other form of group transit, like the bus or a tandem bicycle. Do people still use those because they sound fantastic?
The order doesn't apply to children under the age of 10 or anyone who's not safely able to wear a mask. And all of this actually brings us to our main story for the afternoon, which is Ohio's new public health advisory alert system. Yeah, the name is not super catchy, but it is super important to understand because this is likely what will be used to determine how the state responds to coronavirus in the foreseeable future.
For more than a month, DeWine has teased toward a more localized approach, and after the state saw a spike in cases, he doubled down on that idea, creating this new system to keep everyone in touch with how the virus is spreading in their specific county.
He even used this new system as the basis for issuing that 7-county mask order, you know, the one I told you about like 30 seconds ago. But okay, how does it work? What does this look like? Well, the man took like 2 hours to explain it, so let's just get to the juicy parts.
First, there are 4 levels, yellow, orange, red, and purple, with purple being the worst, though it is a lovely color. There's also a list of 7 indicators that are used, like strikes, to determine what level a county is in. So yellow counties have 0 to 1 strikes. At this point, there are 54 counties in this range, which is most, so hooray, great job. Orange counties then have 2 to 3 strikes, and right now there are 27 of them, including Lucas, Wood, and Henry by us. This just means people should be using a higher degree of caution and limiting any in-person interactions. Red counties have, you guessed it, 4 to 5 strikes, meaning you should try to limit yourself to necessary travel only and consider online options. I mean, come on, how much fun is it to put things in that tiny little cart, am I right? And purple counties have 6 to 7 strikes.
Thankfully, there are no counties at that level as of yet, but DeWine did say that Franklin County, which is home to Columbus, is on a watch list. So okay, those are the 4 levels, pretty straightforward, but what exactly are these strikes that leaders are looking out for?
First, they look at new cases per capita, when the data shows that the county had an average of 50 cases per 100,000 people in a 2-week period, that will be 1 strike. In this case, population size does matter. Then they look at sustained increase in new cases. If the number of new cases continually increases for 5 days, that's another strike. Behind door number 3 is actually an interesting data point. Leaders are looking at the percent of cases that are found in non-congregate settings. We know the virus spreads easily in places like nursing homes, but those cases aren't that likely to go beyond those walls and into the general population, which is important to keep in mind when looking at community spread. So when 50% of new cases in a 3-week period are from outside of congregate care facilities, that will be another strike. Next is a sustained increase in trips to the ER. This looks at the number of people who go into the ER with COVID-19 symptoms or with a confirmed case of the virus. If there is an increase in these visits over a 5-day period, that county will get, yep, another strike. But it's not just the ER. They're looking at sustained increases in outpatient visits and hospitalizations. And if those increase over a 5-day period, that's 2 more strikes. And finally, ICU bed occupancy. And rather than looking at county data, this actually looks at regional numbers of coronavirus and non-coronavirus use of ICU beds. This really just gives us an idea of how full our hospitals already are. So if regional occupancy goes above 80% on 3 days of a 7-day period, that, my friend, is a strike.
So what does this mean for us? Really, it's just a quick way for us to get an idea of how the virus is spreading in our own backyards so we can then go forward and make the best decisions for ourselves. It also could give us a little bit of insight into what local leaders could be deciding in the near future.
Mask mandates have already been suggested in Toledo, but a number of issues on city council, namely the federal charges pending against a third of them, that process has hit a bit of a speed bump.
But that is all I have for you today. I have a link in the description of this video that has all my sources, including the recipe for these monster cookies, which are actually gluten-free because apparently the closer you get to 30, the less real food you get to enjoy. But these, I promise you, regardless, are top tier. So try them out. Let me know if you do. And if you want to keep sipping tea with me every week, make sure you like the video, hit subscribe, whatever YouTubers say. But with all of that, go out there, make informed decisions, and I'll see you next time.